Hello, beautiful folk. This is Yosara again with Sweetie Talks. This month we are doing 31 videos in 31 days talking about women's wellness and the struggle that we have with maintaining consistent practices. And again, if you want to catch all of these videos, they're all going to be uploaded on our YouTube channel, so look for it there, as well as in snippets all over our social media. So make sure to join the conversation and use hashtag Sweetie Talks. So, yesterday we talked about the distinction between wellness and fitness. And we talked to Millie, and Millie kind of told us what wellness meant to her. And it was beautiful. She told us about her family and how her community is what holds her. So today we're talking to Aya. For those of you that are taking class here, Aya is a phenomenal instructor. Aya is an amazing dancer. She's a yoga instructor. She's a healer. She's amazing. And she's also really shy, so pardon the nervous. So today we want to talk to her about whether or not, as a wellness and fitness professional actually, whether or not there is a distinction and what she feels is the difference between fitness and wellness. So Aya, I actually happen to know that you're really great at wellness. And can you tell us a little bit about, you know, whether or not you feel that there is a difference and what the distinction is? So what do you think? Are they two different things?
I think they're almost the same.
Okay.
But people confuse them to be different.
Yes.
Because how could you be fit? You could be like physically fit, but what if you're not mentally fit?
That's right.
You could be like, you know.
That's right. And we've actually heard of people that are amazing fitness gurus that have a heart attack at 35.
Yeah.
It has happened. And many people have come forward saying this. So I think you're right. So besides your fitness and dance and physical practices, what are your wellness practices?
Try my best, which I'm trying.
Yeah.
Not perfect. Eat healthy.
Mm-hmm.
Trying to drink more water. Relax. And also trying to do things that I enjoy doing that I haven't been doing, like reading, relaxing, even just like watching TV, because I didn't have a TV for like 4 years.
Yeah.
And obviously you shouldn't like watch too much TV, but just like doing something fun, maybe seeing your friends, trying to reach out to family more.
Do you feel like one affects the other, or in other words, when your wellness is off, is fitness more difficult?
Yeah, well, because for example, you could try and be, like you're trying to be fit, like sometimes I'm like that, like, okay, I'm gonna get fit, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna like go 150%, but what you gotta realize is that's not realistic if you'd be like, okay, I'm gonna join the gym or I'm gonna join the studio, I'm gonna take like 150 classes a week. That's not gonna work. Your body is different every day depending on your lifestyle, like maybe you have kids, maybe you have a crazy job and then you wanna come and take like 5 classes a day. That's just not gonna work.
Right, it's not sustainable.
Yeah.
And we talk about that with our clients. We let them know that, you know, it's about finding what you like. And if you do fitness and with things and activities that you actually enjoy, it can be wellness as well, right? It can be a part of that. And last question.
Yay! I don't know if I'm answering them right. I'm not really sure what I'm saying.
You're doing perfect.
Okay.
What are the things that help you stay on track with both your fitness and your wellness? Is it your routine? Do you think your job, for example, forces you to keep wellness at the forefront? What are the...
I actually think that like fitness professionals, yoga instructors, people in the wellness industry are like really susceptible to like being like not actually taking care of yourself, because I think what you mentioned in your video, you're always like trying to like take care of other people, especially when you're an instructor and you're like, you know, like you're on the ground level, you're going here, there, everywhere, teaching 1,000 classes a day, and you're giving your energy, you're like helping other people get better, and then, you know, sometimes you might neglect your own practice. I know that happens to a lot of, that happened to me at one point. I'm a bit more on track now. I know it happens to like a lot of my friends that are yoga teachers. They just
burn out.
They like stop practicing. They don't even like yoga. They just teach yoga. Like, it's crazy. So just trying to find a balance and like just coming back to like, why are you in this field in the first place? Why? Because it did something for you, so you need to try and remember to do that yourself to be able to like give you know, a better class, instead of just, you know, like when you lose passion for something, you're just doing it, you're just delivering a class, you're just blah.
I've heard this.
Do up dog, down dog, 1, 2, 3, namaste, and you're like, oh, I gotta go over here now. So just
that was awesome. That was perfect. Thank you so much. So, for those
I'm
of you...
I'm not crazy, by the way.
No, she's really not. I'm
nervous on the camera, okay?
Aya's fantastic, and she's nowhere near this nervous when she's teaching her amazing classes. So, you can find Aya's classes here at Sweetwater Dance and Yoga. Check our schedule. She teaches Saturday mornings as well as Thursday morning classes.
7 a.m.
7 a.m. Come on. Get the wellness in early. Put it first.
If you practice in the morning, you're a bit stiffer, so I don't know if some people like practicing later, but if you practice in the morning, you get it out of the way, you can feel energized.
Yeah. Yep. You start the day off right, and you prioritize yourself and your wellness. It came first, and that's beautiful. That's a beautiful message to give to your body. You can also find, by the way, Aya at Mindful Movements. So look for her. Is it Mindful Movement the Bronx?
Yes, Mindful Movements BX.
BX. Yes. Mindful Movement BX. So look for her. Thanks again for listening, and we're going to see you tomorrow with more Sweetie Talks and more women's wellness and more beautiful stuff. Thank you so much, y'all. Love and light.